Well, I think that's a lot of pressure when you try to think of how to be the perfect person, knowing that a specific audience is watching. So I've never really lived my life like that. As I've grown up and had kids, I might have a different perspective on maybe the things that I would do or say or wear if I was more conscious of the female audience watching. But then sometimes I feel like if you are too aware, then you start to not become your, you know, you can't live your life yourself fully authentically.
Where's Kim?
Kim is always late.
Get out of our way.
Stop.
Keeping Up with the Kardashians was launched in 2007, and by that time, a reality show about a Hollywood family was far from a new idea. But the show has gone on to be the most successful of its genre, propelling each of the sisters and their mum to massive fame and fortune.
Would you eat a cockroach for $1 million?
A million? Actually, yeah, probably, yeah. Ugh. Mm-hmm. Gross.
I wouldn't eat a cockroach for $1 million.
Well, because you're a billionaire.
You've joked on the show for years with your sisters that you were the favourite daughter until Kylie became a billionaire.
Yes.
Do you have a favourite sister?
I would say Chloe and I are really close in the last few years ever since she's had her baby. So I don't know if it's like a favourite. I love each sister for a different reason, but as far as closeness, me and Chloe are just really close right now.
She was on set today.
She was.
You shared a very intimate moment on the show recently where Kanye criticised your Met Gala.
Yeah.
Outfit. He thought it was too sexy.
Yeah.
You are my wife, and it affects me when pictures are too sexy.
You built me up to be this like sexy person and confidence and all this stuff.
Yes.
And just because you're on a journey and you're on your transformation doesn't mean that I'm in the same spot with you. So.
Okay. All right. Cool.
Why did you decide to put that on the show?
Him and I talked about that, and it was something that was important to him to show on the show because that's where he's at in his life. The one part that I think it didn't show is the dress, because it was supposed to be wet looking coming out of the water. It had nipples on it, and so he really wanted that taken off. But I also think for me just to show every picture perfect moment of my life just is kind of like the Instagram version of the show, and my show's never been like that. And it is totally natural that a husband and a wife would be in like different places in life and just have different ideas about things and having disagreements about things like that. But it's how you handle it and how you compromise and what comes about that I think really shapes our relationship.
Kim's latest gig is working with Uber Eats. And our chat took place on the set of their latest commercial, which has her working alongside the one and only Sharon Strzelecki.
Tonight, I'll be eating pesto gnocchi and garlic bread to keep me carved up. Hey, Kim.
What are you going to have?
Tonight, I'll be eating a chicken schnitty with chips and chicken salt.
Ooh, nice.
Nice.
Kim, I don't mean to be rude, but it's actually pronounced noise.
Nice?
Noise.
Noise.
N-I-C-E, noise.
Noise.
When Kim rolls into town, it's no small operation, and today is no different. There's 150 people back there, 9 trucks here on the street, and in the middle of it all, one iconic Aussie netball player. And after 12 hours on set, you start to get some idea of exactly what life is like on planet Kardashian. I'm trying to work out who's the most famous family in the world, and I think it's a toss-up between the British royals and the Kardashians. And I'm wondering if you feel some sympathy for what Harry and Meghan are going through.
I think everyone has their own journey, and I think their journey is extremely personal with, you know, what his mother experienced and how her life was so affected by the spotlight and by paparazzi. So I don't think anyone can really understand what that's like except for them. But I think as I'm older and as I have kids, and what I would want for them is just the safest place. I can definitely empathize with their need for having a secure, safe place and taking time for themselves and having privacy when they need it.
What's the hardest part of being Kim Kardashian?
The hardest part? I mean, I think it's pretty... I'm not one of those people that will complain and say, like, oh, I don't have any privacy, or, like, my life is so different. I think maybe just the hardest part is keeping up with my friends. Just really, I have the best friends that I could ever have wished for, and they're all girls that I grew up with. But it's, you know, you do have to put in work to maintain those relationships.
Kim married rap superstar Kanye West in 2014, and together they have four children, North, Saint, Chicago, and Sam.
Can you share with me your secret to good parenting?
I would say you just have to wing it. My sisters and I are on a group chat, always getting parenting advice.
But they don't get advice from me. Can I get on that chat, please?
Do you worry sometimes that the kids are growing up, obviously in a very glamorous lifestyle? There's a lot of wealth around them.
I do. I talk about it all the time. I talk about it with a lot of friends that are in, you know, similar situations or different situations. I research parenting probably more than anything else, from reading tons of books to having conversations with a lot of people. I think no matter what you're given and no matter what you have to treat people with respect. And so I do the best that I can, and I really do believe that my children are really well adjusted and know that they are blessed, but understand to be really compassionate, and they're really good people, and that is my number one goal in life.
Now, I know that Kanye is not keen on North wearing makeup.
Yes.
How do you two go? Because parenting can really expose different ideas that parents can have.
I mean, about the makeup thing, I don't think a kid should really be wearing makeup either. You know, I think sometimes if you don't understand a rule, it's good to really learn and ask your friends, and for, in my case, my siblings, what they would do, bounce ideas around, and develop a way that we're gonna parent and rules that we have, and we always have to stay aligned.
Kim's latest career move is perhaps her most surprising yet. She's following in her dad's footsteps and training as a lawyer. She's already been campaigning for prison reform in the US and was instrumental in the release of Alice Johnson, a great-grandmother who was serving a life sentence for drug charges. I'm imagining you've been inundated with requests from people wanting you to do an appeal on their case. How on earth do you decide who you're going to help?
Well, so far, I think it's like 34 people that I have helped now release. So, you know, some situations might be really easy and might just be really specific on, okay, they have the requirements to get out, but they need an attorney and they need the funds. So an attorney will actually do the work.
Who provides the funds?
Well, I would. So that's like an easy way to help with a specific situation, but then there might be a deeper situation that needs lobbying and phone calls to the president or to the governor, and just working together with a bunch of officials that really need to step in to change someone's life.
She's got good genes, that I can tell you. Good genes for everything. And she's been a real friend, and her husband has been a real friend of mine, Kim Kardashian West.
So I'm thinking you've got the president on speed dial. Is that right?
I wouldn't say speed dial, but...
But close.
I have a good relationship with the White House, and they've been extremely helpful in prison reform and justice reform. And that's been an amazing transformation of seeing that at the beginning of the presidency, maybe wasn't so open to the idea of any prison reform, and completely changing and meeting a lot of amazing people along the way and having a change of heart has been a beautiful journey of me to watch as well.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Is Kanye going to do as he says and run for president?
That we'd have to ask him. I'm not sure if he says it. I would believe it.
Lisa, amazing. Two things. Mm-hmm. Number one, please tell me that wearing your bathrobe is now a thing we can do anywhere all the time.
It looks like it.
Fantastic.
If I'd known, I would have worn mine.
And the second thing is, are you going to be on Keeping Up with the Kardashians now?
Well, they were actually filming that day. That's why the day was so crazy and why she had to wear the bathrobe, because she had no time, because she was doing the Uber Eats ad as well as filming Keeping Up with the Kardashians. And, yes, I've signed the waiver.